Welcome, folks, one and all, to Let's Play Simon the Sorcerer, a point-and-click adventure game from way back when. And we are talking, this thing was out on the Amiga. And it was also released, I believe, for the Amiga's console as well. Yes, for people that know there was a Commodore console, and not the old ones, a newer one, the one that ended up not working very well. Simon the Sorcerer is a point-and-click adventure game of a unique tone, and the main character here, as we can see, who's just plugging in his Discman there, or even Walkman, heck, that's a cassette player, is Simon. Simon is a 12-year-old boy, in normal times, who suddenly found this dog called Chippy. And as you could see in the opening sequence, he was deciding that he was going to use his, well, methods of amusing himself by putting the dog in, well, an appliance for the cleaning of clothes, shall we say. And there was the spellbook and the goblins and everything else. Now he's on a quest to go and save a wizard from an evil man. And if anybody hasn't noticed, there's a fridge in the corner! Before I can start this, I have to say, yeah, I've been fiddling around with the sound, so hopefully this is fine, but there are no subtitles. This is run by ScumVM, and you can only either have subtitles or voice acting. And in this instance, I went for voice acting. So, apologies in advance for that. So, what are we doing in this game? Well, we need to go find those wizards! But first, we need to examine everything.
A strange picture with strange symbols around it.
Why are you looking at me? You're breaking the fourth wall as soon as the thing begins, Simon!
It must be Calypso's junk.
Can I pick any of it up?
What would I want with that pile of junk?
Ugh, can I consume it?
That's not part of a balanced diet.
Oh, can I talk to it?
It is impossible to strike up an intelligent conversation with an inanimate object.
Can I open it?
It was never designed to be opened.
Can I close it?
It was never designed to be closed.
Can I wear it?
My sense of fashion dictates otherwise.
Can I move it?
I don't see the point.
Can I use it? With that.
That doesn't work.
Can I give it to the dog?
That's just plain silly.
Fine. Let's look at the dog.
It's my little dog, Chippy.
Who you wanted to put in an appliance for cleaning clothes.
I haven't got the heart to wake him.
Fair enough. Let's look at the things that are important then, like the fridge.
You wouldn't expect to see one of those here.
Yes, there's a fridge in this game, and we're going to open it. What's in it?
The door appears to be stuck shut.
Oh, yeah. Okay. What about that?
It's a fine example of its kind.
Well, let's take it. You put it in your hat. Well, it worked. Let's look at the notes.
Do you really want me to read it all again?
No, thanks. Ugh. Look at the postcard.
Use it to save or load a saved game. Or if you're a complete wimp, then you could use it to quit out of the game.
Ugh. Dorothy's got sass, I see. Well, there's not much else we need in this place. There's a drawer here. Let's look at that.
A shallow drawer in the wizard's writing desk.
Let's open the drawer then.
Oh, look. There's a pair of scissors in here.
Let's pick up the scissors then. While we're here, let's look at the scissors.
They look like hairdressing scissors.
Why would you have hairdressing scissors?
It's a fine example of its kind.
Why don't we look at the bed? Nope, there's nothing else we can do here, it would seem. Literally. Let's look outside. Oh. You'll note that Simon runs everywhere. This is advantageous. Anything interesting? Look behind the cottage. Well, look at the comp. What's this? It's a compost heap!
A heap of highly magical and smelly compost.
We want some of that!
That would completely overpower my pheromones.
We'll wear it?
My sense of fashion dictates otherwise.
Talk to it!
It is impossible to strike up an intelligent conversation with an inanimate
object.
Let's
eat the compost!
I won't bother if that's all the same to you.
Git. Nope, that's clearly not the way we need to go. Maybe the other way. What about this way? Yeah, here we go. A blacksmith. That's what we're looking for. Hey, buddy. You okay?
Muscular.
Yes, he is. What else can we look at? A clapper?
It's a metal bar from inside a bell.
Can we pick it up? Yes, we actually can. I highly hope we need that. What about the rope?
It's a fine example of its kind.
You're not even going to describe it. Well, I'm going to pick it up.
No one will miss this old thing.
No one ever misses rope, and yet it's always used in these games. Okay, what else have we got to look at? The door. I hope you guys don't mind the hammering.
It's large, wooden, and completely locked.
Oh, well, you've beaten that. Let's talk to the blacksmith. Hey, buddy.
Good morning. He's too engrossed in his work to hear me.
Ugh. Well, we'll go this way then, I guess. Ooh. There's a way down. Ooh. This is the pub they were talking about. It's a nice looking pub, though.
It was never designed to be opened.
I'm not trying to open. I'm looking at
Apparently,
it.
Apparently, the place is called the Drunken Druid.
That's quite a nice name. Let's look at the door.
It's a sturdy wooden door.
Let's open the door! With the power of psychic, because apparently I didn't press it. Let's walk in. What's that?
I wonder what this is doing here.
Can we use the food machine?
I haven't got any quarters.
Bugger. Can we open it?
It was never designed to be opened.
Okay, fine. Look at the dwarf, then.
He looks completely out of it.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Do you see that? Look at that. I see it.
It's a box of safety matches.
Well, we shall pick them up. Why? My adventure sense tells me to. We need those. The little dingle said we needed them. Suppose I should talk to the dwarf, shouldn't I? Hello! Fine! He's got a nice beard, though. On a completely nonsensical note, let's look at some other people. Let's look at the Valkyries.
I'm looking.
Oh, dear.
I'm looking.
Oh, dear. Look at the barman, I guess.
Jolly-looking barman.
What are you? You're not an object. However, let us do something completely random. I want that beard. I'm not kidding. I want that beard. How does this work? Because...
it's made from real dwarf hair.
Can we wear it?
I don't think it's much use to me here.
Oh, that's a pity. Well, we need to talk to someone. Let's talk to the barman, he'll give me plot dump.
Good morrow, barkeep.
Good morrow, lad.
Incidentally, it's a fine establishment. Makes me a wet wizard barkeep, oh dear.
Incidentally, it's a fine establishment you have here.
Thanks.
I'm very proud of the Drunken Druid.
Are you?
It's my pride and joy.
Good.
People come from the whole village to raise a jar in here.
The village?
I've got a reputation of fine service and even finer ales.
Oh, good.
Business is especially good at the moment, though, because of some guy called Sordid.
Oh? How is this Sordid helping your business?
How is Sordid helping to boost business?
It's a long story. Apparently, he wants to take over the entire world using black magic.
Okay.
Anyway, as a result, all the heroes are donning rusty armor again and coming back into service.
Oh.
All of them seeing themselves as the saviors of the world.
Okay.
The thing is, though, they all stop here for a drink on the way. I've seen all sorts go through here. Warriors, wizards, priests, assassins, and not one has been seen again.
So what?
I don't see what all the fuss is about personally. So he may be a bit power crazy and all that, but who isn't these days?
Oh.
Old fella keeps himself to himself. He don't bother us, we don't bother him, and that's that.
You talk a lot, don't you?
You talk a lot, don't you?
I'm a bartender. The punters expect local gossip and general small talk from me.
I come from another dimension!
I come from another dimension.
As I said, we get all sorts in here.
He doesn't care.
I quite fancy a drink now. Make mine a wet wizard.
Hang on a moment.
He's gonna pour water on my head, isn't he?
I'm sure I've got some sparrow juice down here somewhere. Where is it? Oh, Helen Buckshot.
Helen Buckshot?
I'm sorry, sir. I can't seem to find any sparrow juice at the moment.
That's okay. I'm underage anyway.
Anything else, sir?
How about a warlock surprise?
How about a warlock surprise?
Hang on a moment.
Gotcha.
I'm sure I've got some essence of fruit back down here somewhere.
You don't.
Where is it?
Nope, you don't have it.
Oh, Helen Buckshot.
Helen Buckshot.
I'm sorry, sir, I can't seem to find any essence of fruit bat at the moment.
That's okay, I'm underage anyway.
Anything else, sir?
Nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you. So long.
See ya.
There's more we have to talk to him about, unfortunately.
Hello again.
Yeah.
No.
No. See you around.
What? No! So, okay, let's talk to the Nubar Valkyries.
Hello. What do you want, boy?
Oh god, what do you do in the sun? Do you come here often? If I said you had a beautiful body, would you hold it? No. Would you come here often? Hello. Oh dear. Seems your magic is not working, Simon. Hello.
Hello.
Oh.
What do you want, boy?
I just wanted to ask you some questions.
I just wanted to ask you some questions.
You're not from some sort of magazine, are you?
Yes, I am.
Okay, then.
What? You're not married, are you? Ah, what do you know about the evil wizard Sordid?
Do you know anything about the evil wizard Sordid?
That's why we're here, actually.
Oh?
We've journeyed from the far northern steppes to battle with him.
Oh, great.
Through the perilous wastelands of Kring, pausing only to defeat the evil tribe of Wedgie the Merciless. Across the plains of death and the fields of doom, where we liberated the city of Tormer from the dark hordes of Kalish. We're now preparing to attack the Sorcerer's Tower and save the world.
Okay.
Again!
Where is it? Those are all terrible questions.
You're not married, are you?
No.
Oh. What are your... Oh dear. No more questions.
No more questions, ladies. See ya.
Better give us a good review, or else.
Phew, it's awfully hot in here.
Yes, yes it is. And thank you for the first video of Simon the Sorcerer, where we've cut off a man's beard, stolen things, and generally been an annoyance to everyone! As a 12-year-old boy! In a wizard's outfit! At least there's only one Zed in the name. So folks, until then, I'll catch you later. See you then.